a Friday come babe. On a hippie trailhead full of zombies. I met a strange lady, she made me nervous. She took me in and gave me breakfast. And she said, do you come from a land down under?
Hi everyone, I'm Jen Kingwell and I'm privileged to be the designer for the Quiltmania Mystery Quilt for 2019 in conjunction with Motor Fabrics. The images at the intro are walking into my store, Amity Textiles. I'm really fortunate to live and work in Torquay on the amazing surf coast of Victoria, Australia. I named this quilt Marshal. The meaning of the word is to assemble or arrange, to gather, to call together. I thought this was symbolic of what we will do with a project of this nature. It will be made by crafters from all over the world. We will have different beliefs. We will look different. We will have different skill levels, but we will be brought together as we stitch. I'm a hand piecer, so I will be showing you how I stitch this project together, but of course you may stitch it however you wish. We will be using my new fabric range from Motor called Remix. I love this range as it is all my favourite prints from previous lines and they're just recolored. So this is Remix, my new line that Motor have produced for this project. And here are the fabrics that you will receive in the first bundle. This year the fabrics will be sent to you in a slightly different way. As the project is really, really scrappy, you're going to need lots and lots of fabrics right from month one. In amongst these fabrics, there are also 14 of the fabrics that we love to call at Moda the lollies, because they're a little bit like a quilter's candy. And these will give you a huge number of prints to play with. They're so useful to scrap quilters as there are 8 5-inch panels that run across the width of the fabric. So you get 8 different prints on each fabric. Each month you'll be using all of these fabrics, so be considerate when you're cutting them. You'll receive the first bundle, as I said, at the beginning of the quilt, and the second bundle will come out with month 3, and you'll just reuse and reuse from each fabric as desired. There are also acrylic templates that will be available through any of the stores that are participating in the program. These stores are listed in your Quiltmania magazine, and also a list of them will be on my jenkingwelldesigns.com website. The template shapes are also printed in the magazine, so you can make your own templates from plastic. They will look something like this. This is not exactly how they'll be in the magazine, because I'm filming this before the magazine is actually in print. But this is the idea, and you will just be able to pop this and trace onto the plastic and you're ready to go. Of course, with the acrylic templates, rotary cutting, machine piecing, but also useful for hand piecing, and I'll show you how to use both of these. If you're going to be cutting from the paper sheet, for hand piecing, I don't include the seam allowance, so I would be just cutting on the inner line. But of course, if you're going to cut them and machine piece them, you will need to include your 1/4-inch seam allowance. So this is month one, or part one, and this is what we'll be working on today. So I'm going to show you how to use these acrylic templates for hand piecing. Of course, if you were going to machine, you would just pop your template on your cutting mat, fabric cutting mat, and rotary cut around the edge. There are a lot of inset seams and mitres in this quilt, so I would still mark through the registration holes your 1/4-inch junctions, because then you will know where to stop and start stitching on your sewing machine. When I hand piece, I never stitch my 1/4-inch seam allowance down, so I'm only ever stitching from my registration point to my registration. So I like to trace on some sandpaper or a sandpaper board, medium grade. I just pop my fabric right side down, so I'm tracing onto the wrong side of my fabric, and I just draw around the edge of the template with a soft lead pencil, either a 2 or a 2B lead. It transfers much easier to the fabric. I hope you can see some of these light lines that I've drawn here around the edge of my template. To save fabric, I do like to butt my template right up to the line that I've previously drawn. That will just save a little bit of fabric each time. As I said, just drawing around the outside edge and then marking your registration holes or points through the little holes that are pre-drilled in these templates. Part of the advantage of these is that you do get these accurate registration points, and that is important with this quilt. Then to get your quarter inch seam allowance, you can just pull your template to the side, line your etched quarter inch line on your template onto your drawn cutting line, and then just rule dot to dot on your fabric each side. Now, of course, here we have a curve, and you may think that that's not going to be that easy, but in actual fact, it's not difficult at all. This is template A, and if you look at your pattern and find your corresponding template, in this case, it is template B, that is going to sit onto template A. Now, if I lay those etched lines on top of each other, you can see that those registration points match perfectly. So it means that if I pop that etched mark onto my drawn line and draw along the edge, etched mark on drawn line, draw along the edge, I will have a perfect quarter inch seam allowance there as well. So this is the first piece that we're going to be working on. I've pre-cut these. You can see that I've marked my seam allowance onto them all, and then I'm going to stitch together in pairs, all right? So I'm going to stitch two together, as I've done here. Then I'm going to stitch those two pairs together, as I have done here. And then your centre seam across will be just one long seam. And this helps to get a really lovely, neat junction right there in the centre of the block. I'll show you how I stitch on the very next part when I'm putting it together, because I want to show you how to use the registration marks as well. So once you've sewn your eight centre pieces together, we'll be moving on to making this outer ring here, which is what I want to show you now. And then we'll insert this piece into this piece, which I will show you at the end. So I'm going to cut template D and just show you how this goes together. You can see here, hopefully, that template C, which is this one, doesn't extend all the way around. It stops here. And then template B, which is this one, extends a little further, and then there's a little part that you'll stitch together at the end of template D. So when you're tracing this one, whether machining or hand, I do suggest that you place a little dot through all your registration marks, like so. Now, if I pop this template onto the dark, hopefully you can see here it has a little C in the seam allowance and a little B in the seam allowance. And what this is referring to, this is where the tip of your template C will stitch to. And then this is where the tip of your B will stitch to. And so if you've marked them, it makes it so much more accurate when you start putting them together. All right, so I've just written in the seam allowance here. I'm not sure if you can see, hopefully you can, but I've just written a little C and a little B in the seam allowance, just to give myself a little reminder that that's where the tip of C will stitch to, this is where the tip of B will stitch to. Now, I have previously stitched a couple of these together, okay? So you can see that C is just being stitched to this point. And then when we add in template B, you're going to stitch from the end, but of course template B is going to stitch up a little further onto template D. So once again, I am cutting and butting this up to my previously cut pieces. This is one of the lollies which I have used throughout the quilt. The centre light, the light greys used in the background of the centre are all cut from the lighter panels of the two grey lollies that you will receive. So you're just going to butt it right up against a cut line or a drawn line, trace around the edge, rotate your template round, butt it up against the line, and you will have plenty of fabric to get these out. Of course, you're going to have a little bit of bias here and here. You are a little bit on the straight of grain here, but don't worry, there is plenty of stretch with this being cut on the bias edge to get it to piece beautifully. So here is my template D that I've traced previously and marked my little registration marks, and this is my template C, and this is how they're going to fit together. So right sides together. I do like to stitch with my inner curve facing me, so I'm going to pop this piece on top, and I'm just going to grab a pin and pin the registration mark that I've made from the centre of template C and match that into the registration mark of the centre of template D. So I'm just going to match those two little dots like so. And pin. Then I will find the end registration point of template C, thread in the way, and match that to the registration dot that said template C, or the little C for template C on your reference point there. You can go ahead and do the other end at this stage if you would like. And now it's just a matter, because you've cut this and you've got some bias in here, you can just stretch that until those two pieces fit together perfectly. People worry about stitching curves, but they're easier than stitching straight edges because you just have this wonderful bias stretch in them and you can make anything fit together. Now I find with the acrylic templates that because you're so accurate with your cutting and your quarter inch, most times if I have my raw edges together, my two lines are just going to fall on top of each other. And I'm going to just show you how I stitch. I am an Aurifil girl. I love 50 weight thread for hand stitching. I also use it for machine stitching. And this is my favourite colour, 2375. It's like a little chameleon. It just blends with anything. So if you're scrap quilting and you're not sure what coloured thread to use, I find this one is incredibly useful. it's just a very dusty sort of funny pink colour, not one you would pick up off the shelf, but it is fantastic. I'm just going to start stitching right at the registration mark at the tip of my seam line on my template C here, and I'm going to take a little bite. Now I have no knot in the end of my thread. I'm going to do a little flat knot or a tailor's knot. I'm going to take a second little bite on top of that one. Now your thread will sit one side of the needle or the other. I then pick up the threads in the eye of the needle and I bring them up and under the tip of the needle in the opposite direction to that first thread. All right, so if that first thread is sitting to my left or closest to me, I'll take the thread to the other side. Pull through and you'll just notice as this thread pulls down, it just forms a little figure eight and ties a beautiful flat knot at the end of your work there. And then all it is now is a tiny running stitch on the stitching line. Now just do as many stitches as you're comfortable with. I usually do roughly six, but there's no real number that you have to do. But each time I pull my needle and thread through, I do take a little back stitch when I start sewing, just for a little added security in that seam. If you want, as you stitch along, you can turn your work over and check that you're stitching on the line at the back, but you'll get more confident as you stitch and you won't need to do that so often. Just remove the pins as you go and just merrily keep stitching along. Little back stitch again when I start. and I'm just going to stitch all the way across, and I'm going to stitch over to this registration point on this side here. So with the lollies fabric, with the 8 panels across the width, you get this little separation line in the middle of them. It's like a little black and white stitching line. Now, a lot of people just cut that out and don't use it, but I have used this line extensively through the quilt. So this is template B. If you weren't using this fabric, you would just cut two of these, one and one in reverse, and stitch them together down the center so that you had two different fabrics. But I'm just going to show you how I cut them from the lollies fabric. So I popped the center registration marks, the stitching line, the etched quarter inch stitching line, right on the white dotted line down the center of the fabric, and then I drew my registration lines in, traced around the edge of the template halfway, not worrying about this cutting edge here, because now I am going to flip this template over, match those registration dots, as you can see. Once again, I've got the etched quarter inch line on the white dotted line on the fabric, and I'm just going to trace around the other side of the template and then mark in. Sorry, I forgot to do that on this side. Of course, I would mark in that little registration point there that goes with template C. All right, and so then you end up with something that looks like this when you cut it out, and you've got that little black and white line up the center to use as a feature. So what I've done is, in this center panel of the quilt, there are 8 of these, so I've gone ahead and stitched all 8 of mine together, so stitching template C to template D, and now we are going to add in our points as we go around. All right, so we're going to stitch these down the side. So what I normally do is I'll stitch all of them to the same side, either the right or the left, it doesn't matter, but I'm going to add one to each side of these as so, and then I'll come back and join the other seams and join this into a full ring. So I'm going to pin this piece to this piece. Now, you may find it easier if you pin with it facing you this way, because you can see your registration point here that you are going to match to the registration point at the tip of template B. So you can pin that one first. I'd then go ahead and pin down this end just to stop it from moving. All right. And then just take that little piece of seam allowance out of the way, and we'll pin matching your registration point that refers to C to the tip of your C template. So I'm going to start stitching at this point here. So I'm stitching from this dot, all right, where I've pinned. I'll just do my little flat tailor's knot again. One bite, second bite, thread from the eye of my needle up under the tip, pull it down firmly, and now I'm just going to stitch on my drawn line. But I'm only going to stitch down to the next registration point, and I'm just going to take that seam allowance out of the way because I don't wish to stitch that seam allowance down. All right, so I'm just going to stitch to that registration mark here. All right, so the little registration mark that says C. Do a little back stitch there. And now I'm wanting to actually stitch the remainder of the template B to my C piece, the grey piece, all right? So what I'm going to do is just skip my needle through and bring it out at that registration point. And now the rest of my seam is between these two pieces. So I'm taking this template D piece and the seam allowance right out of the way. So I hope that makes that a little clearer for you. So I've actually gone ahead now and sewn this together. Really very, very simple. You've made this circle to begin with. Once you've joined all your pieces together, this forms the outer ring. And all I've done is match the seam junction of my center circle to the center of each of the black and white lines all the way around, and then you will just pin. Once again, I do pin with this facing me because that's my inner curve, and just stitch. I skip through my seam allowances so that they're always floating in the breeze, and excuse me, I'll just turn this over. But what that does is it makes it very, very easy when it comes to pressing. For you to be able to manipulate your seam allowance and distribute the bulk of your seam allowance once you get to the pressing stage. So that's month one, or section one, completed, and I really hope you enjoy this journey with me.